Okay, when looking at a greenhouse, because it's a permanent structure, we should be very concerned with the location and the orientation of that particular structure, because it's going to be fixed in place and we want to maximize plant productivity within that particular grow area. So important to make the distinction between greenhouses and high tunnels. Greenhouses are permanent structures. They typically have heat and electricity and a permanent floor. Generally speaking, compared to high tunnels, they are more expensive and they can cover larger areas. High tunnels are the basic structures, are basically poly here on hoops. Plants are grown right in soil. As a result, they're less expensive. They don't really allow for a full calendar year production, especially in colder climates, and typically cover 4,000 square feet or less. Now, focusing again on the greenhouse production, these are permanent locations. So as a result, growers have control over many of the climatic conditions. They also provide consistency and a fixed plant moving and support structures here, because they are solid fixed structures. It allows growers to plan accordingly to maximize plant production. They're well suited for full year production, and then you can have supplemental lighting added also to them. So this is a cloudy day, and you can see, a little hard to see, not a lot of sun. We have some supplemental lights on. Air circulation also is important, so that's helping us maintain our plants in the right photo period, and also receiving sufficient light. Again, those permanent locations allow for adequate planning and running here of irrigation lines, of heating lines. You can also see supplemental lighting in here. Now, the location of the greenhouses should be an area that gets maximum sunlight exposure for the entire year. Large flat areas can have easy access to water and electricity to run to them is advised. So it might be, an ideal location right in the middle of a field here, but if we can't run water, electricity, that's going to present an issue. You want to consider also ease of access by vehicles to transport material to and from the facility. That could be potting media, that could be end product. You don't want to have it in the middle of nowhere. You want to kind of pick a good location and consider all of these particular factors. Now, the orientation of the greenhouse should be based on the season. It's going to match up with the main productive cycle. For fall and winter spring production, it's advised to orient the greenhouse in an east to west to help capture a lower sun angle effectively. However, a north to south orientation is advised to maximize light penetration and other benefit ventilation also. So the orientation may not be 100% chosen because there's constraints of certain areas, but depending when you want to run your main production cycle may influence the exact orientation, the north, south, east, west, direction you choose to run your greenhouse.